And good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I think the Middle East, in one sense, it been in the world agenda last 100 years. I think that since First World War, the Middle East never had peace and security, generally. Within the last decade, Middle East witnessed a wide variety of instability and conflict with multiple actors in each side. The development inevitably had ramifications on security, economic and social development, and quality of human life. The hope for democracy, better life, and the rule of law rising with Arab Spring, unfortunately, succumbed to foreign intervention, regional competition, and domestic oppression. The result is very simple. Fragmented states, polarized societies, widening power vacuum, and burgeoning new threats, including jihadism and radical terrorism. I think we must keep this very complex picture in mind when discussing security and peace in the Middle East. Identifying the domestic and regional root causes of insecurity generators is important in developing remedies to overcome the current downward security slope in the region. Waves of globalization have been fracturing the relationship between the state, state body, and masses in the region for almost two decades. Deepening mismatch between the expectation of growing youth population and state institutional capacity fuels intrastate and interstate discontents. Another systemic factor which is detrimental to the region is military and political intervention. The rise of populist and authoritarian leaders inject more ambiguity and reduce capacity of the states to deal with their own problems. Being a battleground, even in the form of proxy wars, for superpowers serves nothing but an insecure regional state system, traumatized by wars and occupation by different forces. Leading regional rot causes that hamper security in the Middle East are three. First, more sectarian tensions, misallocation of natural resources, and the Arab-Israeli conflict. Yemen war, the Syrian crisis, intractable enmity between Riyadh and Tehran, and fragmented Libya are the concrete output of these regional root causes. When discussing the possibility of peace and security, domestic factors should not be overlooked. Poor governance, failures in the fair, equal, and uninterrupted provision of education, and education not based on knowledge and technology, healthcare, lack of basic services, and economic opportunities is one of the main underpinning of instability in the region. Besides clientelist economic networks, elected authoritarianism undermining the rule of law, disregarding human rights, paved the way for radical terrorism in the region. This picture of the region appears to be gloomy at the first sight. However, remedies are still possible. First, turmoiled state in the region needs a novel social contract with its own citizens. This should target increasing political representation mechanism in any country, many countries in the region. Second, regional cooperation is needed for solving the problems. It can be as a regional ownership. This should not give any credit to sectarian approaches which have been crowding the region for many decades. Regional ownership could be influential in solving water problems, the terrorism threat, and migration crisis. The utmost condition of the regional cooperation is mutual respect for sovereignty, territorial integrity, and political independence of regional state. Number three, foreign military intervention should be abandoned. Foreign power have more to gain, not from the intervention, but from cooperation rather than intervention. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.